know, when you paired us up, I wasn't particularly audacious for 10-minute rocking. So I'll get into this because you have a long speech. I thought you did a great job using your intro to set the stage without using time. I think that's a good lesson that Rob can take away from your speech is you set the stage without starting your time, so you were able to use Joey to set you up. So I think that's good. One of the goals of the speech is that you clearly differentiate between your characters. I think you did that very well. You set up different rugs. You can tell who it is. You know, you went back and forth. I've always disliked speeches where somebody moves back and forth. You had to do it. You did it well. It wasn't distracting. And as always, you dress the part, like you do for all your speeches. I'm impressed because I thought when you went down to the floor that there was no way you were getting back up. So you're a horse prime, and I thought you were. The things you wanted me to look for, the first one was audience boredom. And I checked in at 6 minutes, and there were people on the edge of their seats listening. There were some people writing. I don't know if they were taking notes or writing your evaluation. Brandy was on her phone. Shame on you, Brandy. And I think maybe some of the reason you lost listeners was because the pacing of Don Juan, your second one that you wanted me to look for, it was fast. It was hard to keep up with what Don Juan was saying.
Yeah.
I think the other way that you could have kept engaging them is during Don Juan's monologues, instead of looking at Carlos, you could have engaged the audience as you're giving your monologue. So I think that's a way that you could have kept everyone engaged.
Yeah.
Their third one was projection. You did fine there. Everybody could hear you, even though you're looking at notes, you're looking at Carlos, we could still hear you very well, so that wasn't an issue at all. I think the biggest point was slow it down if you can, and then during those monologues, engage the audience. It was good. One thing I don't think anybody picked up on is how it applied to Toastmasters.
Yeah.
So I don't know, maybe if you had extra time, if that's really the point that you wanted to make, which you mentioned, you could have said something at the end just to wrap it up and put a bow on it. This applies to Toastmasters because these four are the enemies of great speeches or whatever.
Yeah.
So that's it. Great job.
Thank you.